Hello and welcome to our guest. So for the first episode, let's talk iPhone 12. I know I'm late to the game, but I had a question since the day one of announcement. Why the flat edges are bad? iPhone 4 and iPhone 5 series had them for like 4 years, and then they just vanished. Apple decided to go on more ergonomic and rounded edges design until iPhone 12, and my question is, why now? So I start searching why they were chosen in the first place, why they made iPhone 4 with flat edges. In 2010, fourth generation of iPhone announced by Steve Jobs, and it was gorgeous, beautiful for that time. And they actually start the name scheme that they continue to have until this day. So before that, they had the iPhone, iPhone 3G, iPhone 3GS, and for the fourth generation, they actually called it the iPhone 4, and they actually continue to numberize the iPhone since then. So anyway, they actually had 8 keynotes at the announcement. And the first one was the design. So there was a few leaks around before the iPhone 4 announcement, but the design was so important to Apple and Steve Jobs himself that he actually said, and I quote,
"Stop me if you've already seen this." "Believe me, you ain't seen it. You've got to see this thing in person. It is one of the most beautiful designs you've ever seen. This is, beyond a doubt, the most precise thing, one of the most beautiful things we've ever made."
So there was a lot of talks about how nice it feels and how premium they nailed front back glass. And around it was actually this stainless steel. And it was very thin for the time. Actually, it was the thinnest phone in the market. And I actually do remember how nice it felt when you go to the store and actually hold one of these phones. There was a lot of phones before that, but all of them made out of plastic and other material that actually didn't feel that premium. It was 9.3 millimeter in depth. It's not a lot of today's standard. Then it was the thinnest phone in the market. Loving or hating Apple, you gotta admit, they actually make a lot of standards in that market. The next generation, the iPhone 5 series, actually had the same design. It was slicker, it was more premium, and again, it was the thinnest phone in the market. Again, why they get rid of it in iPhone 6? The design was an icon for the Apple. Why changing? So there was a few factors that I found. Unfortunately, Steve Jobs passed away a few days after the announcement of iPhone 4S. But the report actually shows that he worked on iPhone 5 and iPhone 5S. That's not that surprising, because these things actually take time to design and go and manufacture enough units of them, so they take 1 or 2 years before the design actually announced. So the design going to be finalized 1 or 2 years prior to the launch of the product. Some said he worked on iPhone 6 design, but from the iPhone 6 suddenly the design language changed, and it was not just the flat edges that changed. Something else changed, something else that there was with the iPhone since the original iPhone. It was the small, reachable, one-hand controllable screen. As a matter of fact, Steve Jobs himself said, "You can't get your hand around it. Might help reception, but no one's going to buy that." He also later on says about the bigger screen of the rival companies. Humorous. So I told you before that he actually worked on iPhone 5, and iPhone 5 actually got a little bit bigger. It just got taller, not wider. It was it was nothing, and I mean nothing, like the change that iPhone 6 and iPhone 6 Plus have made. You can see the level of surprise of the world that even Samsung, Apple rival, actually tweeted that big improvement and innovation can't be changed. Even they thought so. Why they did that? Why they make the iPhone bigger? The answer is kind of simple. They just couldn't resist the trend that their rival made. Until that point, enough Android manufacturers made bigger and bigger phones, and people started accepting them, that it was kind of a hard selling point to have small screen. So they couldn't resist the trend. But you know another trend that they couldn't resist to follow? A trend that they make them sell. It's the next phone in the market. So after iPhone 4, and actually since the iPhone 4, they made their phone thinner and thinner. So with iPhone 6, they wanted to be even thinner. So there's two problems. One, with flat edges, you can't make the phone that thin. So they make the corners and the edges actually round, so it feels more premium. So they make it bigger because of the trend, and they get rid of that flat edges because of the trend that they make themselves. And actually, there is one more reason that I found interesting. iPhones change their design every 4 flagship generation. We have the change after the iPhone 3G or 3GS, and iPhone 4, we had that change. It also happened with iPhone 6 and with iPhone X. Maybe that's the reason. Maybe they wanted to keep that pattern going on, that pattern that actually goes on until today. So that's why they get rid of it in the first place. But why patch now? It's almost felt like they wanted you to say, oh cool, the iPhone had flat edges, that's a new iPhone, and then forgot about it because of the bigger news. Yeah, that's it. What I think happened is the Apple silicon, that M1 chip that is in MacBooks and other Mac products, actually is so huge for them, so big, they didn't want it to iPhone way to collapse with the M1 chips. So they just made some tweaks. There is no news about high refresh rates. There is no Touch ID back, nothing. Just the flat edges, 5G, and MagSafe. You know, they talk in their announcement a lot about the 5G, how they made it possible and made it real. When reviewers get their phone, they all talk about how flat edges feels nice and they love it, and it's the best iPhone they ever had in their hands, and they actually add MagSafe because next year we're going to have a cordless iPhone. And that's it. There's nothing else there. When M1 chips comes out, everyone going to talk about the M1 chips. Again, loving or hating Apple, they're doing something so good that I'm not sure how they are doing it. So here we go. That's why they removed it in first place, that's why it's back now. And the iPhone 12 is actually 7.4mm in depth, just 0.2mm shy of iPhone 5. Almost felt like they couldn't make that black design thinner. Thank you a lot for watching until the end of this video. If you disagree with anything that I'm saying, please let me know them down in the comments section. I will read them all. And if you like them, please give a like. That actually helps me, motivated for making more of these kind of videos. And if you are interested to see what's going to happen in iPhone 13, maybe hit the subscribe button. As we said, that pattern every 4 generation, every 4 big iPhones, as the rumors got around, they actually are removing all the parts of the phone. So that's one big change. And what else could change? We'll talk in the future video. So if you want to see that, make sure to hit the subscribe button. And also, we have lots of videos like this coming up, and if you like them, thank you again for tuning in. Have a very, very nice day. Stay safe, goodbye, and I will see you in the next episode.